हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल सीएसआई एंड नेट केमिस्ट्री फैक्ट्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द सीएसआई एंड नेट 2019 डिसंबर पार्ट सी क्वेश्चन। सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन ऑन योर स्क्रीन। यू कैन सी हियर द फर्फ्यूरल इज ट्रीटेड विद अल्फा बीटा अनसैचुरेटेड कीटोन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सोडियम साइनाइड एंड डीएमएफ एज अ सॉल्वेंट। सो गाइस, इन दिस क्वेश्चन द इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट इज अल्फा बीटा अनसैचुरेटेड कीटोन इज ए इलेक्ट्रोफाइल एंड दिस फर्फ्यूरल डिहाइड आल्सो इलेक्ट्रोफाइल बिकॉज दिस फर्फ्यूरल डिहाइड हैज ए कार्बोनिल कार्बन इन द सीएचओ दैट इज ए इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक कार्बन। And hence, these two electrophiles will not react between them, but in presence of the external nucleophile, the sodium cyanide, it will react. And what will be the fate of the reaction, we have to see by the mechanistic analysis. So guys, let's start this mechanistic analysis and we'll see that which one will be the correct answer. Hello guys, this is the starting material and here you can see the sodium cyanide is given in the DMF solvent. So guys, here we know this is a electrophilic center. And this 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 2 and 4 also electrophilic center, right? So there are 3 electrophilic centers are there. So the sodium cyanide is present in the DMF solvent, and in the DMF is a solvent, is a polar apoptotic solvent. This is the structure of this DMF solvent. So here you can see this is a polar solvent because this will be a positive end, this will be a negative end. So this is a polar solvent. And this is a apoptotic solvent because there is no replaceable hydrogens are present in this molecule. So therefore, this is a polar apoptotic solvent. Okay. So guys, in this case, if you given a salt like sodium cyanide, then what will happen? This cationic part and this is the anionic part. So this cationic part can be stabilized through the electrostatic attraction between this negative end of this dipole, and hence this will be surrounded by this solvent molecules, and hence this sodium will be bounded by the solvent molecules, but this CN minus will be quite free, and in that case that will be a hard nucleophile. Okay, that will be a hard nucleophile. So guys, this hard nucleophile will always prefer the harder electrophiles. So guys, which one is the more harder electrophiles? So we know that this 2 position is harder than this 4 position, but this is a keto and this is a aldehyde. And we know aldehyde ketone is more electrophilic than the normal ketone. So therefore, aldehyde, this carbon will be more electrophilic, and this CN minus will preferably attack to this center, and this double bond O will open. So guys, what will form? This will form this CHO minus and CN. So now this is not so stable because this O minus does not have any stability to give this anion, right? So this O minus will take the proton from here and the negative charge will shift on the carbon. So guys, what will form? This will form where the, this is the OH and this will be the CN, and negative charge will come here. So now guys, you can see this negative charge has a stability via resonance with this furfural ring as well as this CN. So therefore it can go for a resonance stability. And one more thing is that this OH has a minus I effect, right? So so it can pull the electron towards itself because oxygen is very electronegative. Therefore that also stabilizes the negative charge. So therefore there are 3 factors of stabilizing to the negative charge, and hence this is stable carbon ion. Okay, stable carbon ion. So guys, we know that stable carbon ion means the reactivity of this carbon ion will be less. And reactivity will be less means that will be a soft nucleophile. So this is a soft nucleophile. So this soft nucleophile, it will further react with this compound, but it will react in the soft center. So guys, this is a soft nucleophile, and it will prefer a soft center from this molecule. So guys, among this 2 and 4, this 2 is hard and 4 is soft. Why? Because this carbon number 2 is attached with this oxygen, and therefore this is a hard center. And this is far from the oxygen, and there is a resonance stability. So therefore, this 4 is actually a soft center. Okay. So guys, therefore there is a 1-4 addition will take place, and this is known as the Michael type of reaction, where this is the Michael donor and this is the Michael acceptor. So this will donate its electron to this 4 position, and this bond will come here, and a O minus will form. So guys, what will form? This here the CNOOH, and here the newly bond, this is a newly bond formed between this. So the pH will be there, and here this will come and double bond will be there, and here O minus and pH will be there. So guys, this is the structure. So here you can see this is the newly formed bond, right? So now what will happen, this will attack and this will come back and it will take the proton. So guys, here you can see this hydrogen is very close to this double bond and it's a five member type of intermediate it can form, and therefore this proton abstraction will take place specifically from this OH, and hence the negative charge will come on this oxygen, and hence what will form, this, so this CN will be there like this, and this oxygen will take the negative charge, and here this pH will be there, and this double bond O will come here and pH will be there. So guys, this will be the structure. So guys, now what can happen, now this O minus can attack in this position, or this O minus can come back and this CN minus can leave. So we know this attack, after this attacking, this O minus will form here, that will again come back and this will generate the starting material, and hence that will be a reversible reaction. But if the O minus will come this side, then the CN minus is a very good leaving group and it will come out and it will form a keto, and that is an irreversible type of reaction, and hence that will be more favorable reaction. So the CN minus, as is a very good leaving group, it will come out, and that's why the NaCN is acts as a catalyst here, okay? Because the CN minus again joined with this Na plus and it will form the NaCN. So therefore that is a catalyst. So guys, here double bond O will come and the product structure will be this one. So here double bond O will be there, and then pH will be there, and CH double bond O and pH. So guys, this is our final product. This is the final product. So guys, hope you understand this mechanism. Actually, this is very interesting question, because here so many possibilities are there, and we have to see that where is the hard and where is the soft center, and which one will prefer which one. So guys, we have to careful enough when we are doing the mechanism. So guys, this is a very tactical question, and I like this type of question, and thank you so much for watching this video. So guys, let's see then which one will be the correct answer. So guys, if you see these answers, then we can understand this option number 1 and option number 4, there the CHO group of this furfural reagent does not participate in the reaction, and hence that is not possible in this case. So therefore this option number 1 and option number 4 is wrong answer. And among this option number 2 and option number 3, option number 2 is 1,2 addition, and option number 3 is 1,4 addition. So we know guys, in this case 1,4 addition will take place, but 1,2 addition will not take place. So therefore option number 2 is not the correct answer, and option number 3 is the correct answer. So guys, hope you understand this mechanism. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment and subscribe this YouTube channel, and I will come for the next video tomorrow. Thank you so much.